Ignition sequence start. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Liftoff. We have a liftoff.
Hey everybody, this is the Digital Asset Investor, and I'm almost out of coffee. We may have a problem here shortly, because I'm down to, I think, one more K-cup, and then we got a problem, but we'll solve it. Okay, so I want to remind everybody that iTrustCapital, who is one of my sponsors, they're doing this USC game day. I watched USC beat LSU last night, and they're doing iTrustCapital is one of the sponsors of USC football, so they're doing a giveaway where you can win a trip to USC. They're giving away two USC VIP tickets, and it is VIP. I've been there. Trust me on that. Two airfare vouchers, $300 Uber service credit, food and drinks at the game, two-night hotel stay, $400 gift card. You get a T-shirt. You get the hat. So if you want to enter this, in the description of my video, there's an iTrustCapital link. And also there's you get like $100 or $200 if you open an account. It's one of those. So just go check it out, and you'll see the contest on their homepage if you want to enter. And okay, so I wanted to remind everybody of this, because when the market gets quiet and everything, and not a lot's being going on the weekends, especially on X, everybody starts acting ugly and all kinds of stuff. But I want to remind everybody, I always focus on the big picture, because the big picture is this stuff's here to stay, and you're talking about trillions of dollars.
Regulations, because there is trillions and trillions and trillions of dollars on the sideline that's just waiting for some clarity. I sometimes go in and I'm pitching these very conservative organizations like a bank or a sovereign wealth fund, and they're like, well, why should we have any crypto at all? And I'm like, I think it's super irresponsible to have zero exposure. Like, so let's talk about, sizing of a portfolio. And if you want to buy Bitcoin, fine, or Ethereum, fine, or if you want to invest in, one of our funds, that works too. But this is the fastest growing asset class in tech in history. If you want to look at Bitcoin or Ethereum and all the related companies like Kraken and Coinbase and Ripple and Anchorage and others, disclosure, I'm an investor in all those companies. It got first to a trillion, faster than Meta, faster than Google, faster than Apple.
Okay, well, you get the point. There are trillions coming, and I have a hunch that because of the election year, we've already seen what's that guy's name? He's one of the, I think he's a senator, Schumer, one of the most, probably the most corrupt senator in Congress. We've already seen him he's recognized that he needs to do a little bit of a shift on crypto. It would not surprise me if the Democrats tried to pass something so that they could hold it up and say, see, we passed the first ever crypto bill. That would not surprise me if they did that in the next 2 months. 5.5 trillion. Fidelity says Bitcoin could go as high as $1 billion by 2038. Well, let me tell you something, folks. If Bitcoin goes to $1 billion by 2038, then I'm going to have a Peter Thiel Roth IRA because of my iTrustCapital account, actually. So that would be just lovely. Now, here's the problem, and this is why I've never loaded up on Bitcoin. I just have Bitcoin as just an insurance policy, just in case they let this thing live. But here's what Charles Hoskinson says about
it. Bitcoin needs the industry to survive, and sure as hell needs the exchanges and all the other infrastructure, because it's not self-sufficient in that dimension. But the industry doesn't need Bitcoin anymore to survive. It's nice to have a digital asset like Bitcoin that has that reputation and its digital gold. But remember, at the end of the day, it's a token with a deflationary monetary policy. And so at any given moment, another digital gold can form. And if it has good science behind it, it will be just as secure, if not more so. You know, that's why we spent, in a science-based approach with Cardano, 7 years designing a proof-of-stake protocol. you know, from the GKL model to Ouroboros Classic, to Krause, to Genesis, and everything that came afterwards, is that we thought a lot as an ecosystem about how do you build a secure consensus protocol that's energy efficient, but also has all the properties that Bitcoin has. And we were very rigorous with this. And the response to the Bitcoin ecosystem was, oh, it's a scam, it doesn't exist, that technology can't exist, and it's perpetual motion, and proof of stake is wrong. Okay, I just don't see how that survives. It's a religion, it's not an ecosystem. So no, we don't necessarily need Bitcoin, and Bitcoin is gonna have to grow and adapt and change if it wants to survive long-term, you know? And
interesting.
Plenty of people with first mover advantage thought they were invincible. Microsoft did with Windows. And what happened is they never lost Windows, but then just we changed the paradigm. People stopped caring about the desktop, and now we all have cell phones and tablets, and look at Android and iOS versus Windows, the adoption rates. And in a lot of app developers, Windows last. It used to be that if you weren't on Windows, your business would die. Now no one cares about it anymore. So that's the danger there, is that they don't lose the wallet.
All right, well, you get the picture. Now, while I was playing that video, I got an email from Linqto, and they've got a Labor Day, this is Linqto is my sponsor. They got a Labor Day special, $2,500 minimums, extra 5% off until midnight tonight, Pacific time. You can invest with as little as $2,500 in any company available on the platform and diversify your portfolio. You can make as many investments as you want. To celebrate Labor Day until midnight, they're giving an extra 5% off on a minimum order of $2,500 on any company on the platform. That's pretty good. I might need to go check that out myself. Okay, moving along. I wanted to show you this clip. This one is one that I had sent around a while back. This is back in 2021. But just so you know what these people really think about Bitcoin. Here's Elizabeth Warren. She's cheering it on.
Has emphasized it's very difficult.
These people, if they want, and this is why I've never gone in full boat on Bitcoin, is that if they ever wanted to kill, everybody said, oh, you can't kill Bitcoin. Well, there's a lot of ways to skin a cat. One is with the tax code, and one is what they're describing here.
Has emphasized it's very difficult to stop the use of Bitcoin, but you can make it criminal in many different countries if you have an international agreement among countries that they
make it criminal. There's one way, and then he's going to give you the third way.
Bitcoin will not be permitted to be converted into the local currency, then the criminals will be trapped with owning Bitcoin that they can't spend. And I think the best thing to do is for the U.S. And other countries to get together and agree that
so cut off the exit ramps. That's the third way.
None of their countries will Bitcoin be convertible into the local currency. Right.
You think you're just staring down the barrel of an election, but what you're really staring down the barrel of is a choice between the U.S. keeping freedom and totalitarianism. And it's going to involve censorship. It's going to involve any kind of communist type thing you can think of. These people are capable of, and they've shown it to you. I mean, they've shown it to you. All right. Now here is what I consider to be part of the Calvary coming. I believe that if the good guys prevail in this whole thing, I believe Elon Musk will be a big part of what brings about, that takes us into a blue sky with a bright future for everybody, instead of heading in a direction of these sick people that want to control everything. This is an X thread where Elon Musk, he's talking about his satellites, and I've said for a long time on this channel, I believe that those Starlink satellites are going to be everything to all of us. And there's a reason for that. Those Starlink satellites represent a lack of control by all these people that are trying to control the internet down here. Once you have those satellites up there, just look at what Elon Musk says here. He says, our satellites launching in the next few months have inter-satellite laser links, so no local downlink needed. Probably active in 4 to 6 months. And this guy says, how does transmitting into a country without a local downlink work on the regulatory side? And Elon Musk replies and he says, they can shake their fist at the sky. And so he's making the point. And then here's another tweet of his. Starlink's the only high bandwidth internet system that covers all of Earth. So they've got all these low orbit satellites. Well, what have we heard ever since they created XRP and XLM and all these digital currencies? What have we heard coming out of Ripple and all of these other people? We need to have an inclusive banking system. We've got to bank the unbanked. Well, how do you do that? Who are the unbanked? Well, think people out in the middle of the desert in Africa. They don't have a bank. Well, how on earth are you going to bring them online with the financial system? Well, the way you're going to do it is with Starlink satellites that can beam down into places that nobody has ever had internet service. Once you have that, all they need is a phone in their hand, and then in comes crypto, put nodes on the satellites, which I believe that they've already done, and all of a sudden you have an independent financial system that nobody can stop. I've always looked back to that. This is that Ripple commercial where they showed a woman and an astronaut beaming a payment down to it looked like the woman's daughter that was having her wedding. Watch this. I'll just show part of it. Well, I got to hit the refresh button so you can see it. Come on, internet. All right, watch this.
Shodala!
Yeah!
He's got it.
I've got it!
Naruto, Naruto!
Okay, he looks like he's out in the middle of India or Africa or something.
Hello!
So here's the girl at the wedding, and then she needs money from her astronaut mother, I guess.
I got it.
Now, how is that payment going to get to Earth? I ask. I've been asking. Here's Emi Yoshikawa. Great to hang out with the Futureverse team and their vibe at their Vibe side event. And these guys do the have like a gaming platform. And I think they're involved in AI as well. And then they had the XRP Ledger Hackathon in Seoul. And apparently they gave awards to the winners on that. And so here they are. There's the winner's circle. XRP winners. Okay. And then finally, this is what's on the line, folks. And I believe that those satellites are also going to be one of the things that preserves free speech. But what Elon Musk is talking about here is everything.
Free speech is the bedrock of democracy. And free speech is what allows atrocities to be called out and for people to be aware of them. That's why the Germans wanted to shut down the press immediately. So anyway, I think we should do everything we can to preserve free speech. And when we lose free speech, I think we lose democracy.
So he's exactly right. And you need, when you go to that voting booth, you need to ask yourself who has not just been trying to, but who has actively been censoring American speech. And that's not even a question mark. The people that have been doing it is Joe Biden and the Kamala Harris, Comrade Kamala. Those are the people who have been censoring us. It's proven now. We know it for a fact. If you want free speech, in other words, if you want your country, if you want the United States of America, you cannot vote for these commies. You can't do it. And I'm going to show you, this is not just Joe Biden and Kamala Harris, folks. In DAIXRP.com, this goes way back. These commies have been working their plan, and I'm going to show you who it started with. I've always known. I just haven't said it because I haven't really been political on this channel. But I think we're at a point where you have no choice but to be political. I was dragged kicking and screaming because of crypto to this fight, and so be it. DAIXRP.com. We're going to talk about that. I'm also going to show you there's going to be an X Spaces that you need to know about, because they're going to talk about what that guy with the mother of all Twitter files. Remember that? I'm going to show you what you need, where you need to be to hear more about that. I'm the digital asset investor. I'm not an investment advisor. This is for entertainment purposes only. Please subscribe, hit the like button, tell your friends and family. Here we go.